Crossfire on Durian Asia.
If you really like something, you'll go all out for it.
Yep.
Maybe like if, for example, kids nowadays, they love gaming, playing Left 4 Dead or Dota. Stuff like that. That's their thing. And they go on to be professional gamers and earn big bucks out of it. In Malaysia, it's a big business. However, in music, it's not big business. But world cyber games in Malaysia, it's like the thing right now. So I guess a lot of it's on the extension of that would be what is the infrastructure available for people who are involved in the music, the arts, performance arts, stuff like that.
Okay, before we go into that topic, let's just move into Kevin and Andrew. I mean, why? What makes you all continue to pursue your music? You know, into the music. We start with Andrew first.
Well, I don't know. For me, I sort of flunked my SPM because of music.
That means you were born to be a musician.
No, my first ambition was to become a scientist.
Chinese dreams, man.
No, you know why? Because we were busy playing games. You know, we wanted to do like I don't remember why I want to become a scientist. But then after that, I want to become a historian. Because my favorite subject was history. In high school, that's the only like A1 I got for my SPM.
History, you got A1
besides English, besides English lah.
Holy crap! I have no idea why.
Damn.
A lot of people hated me for that, but I don't know.
Hated you?
Because like
they all jealous lah. Jelly.
I don't know for my batch like. The rest of them, they hate history, you know, like, because it's boring. But I don't know, I found it.
I got A2 for history. Yeah, I liked it.
Score, that's why.
I hated history in school, but after school, when you start to understand the country even better and you start to delve into different places around
and
the country.
You question, right?
You start to learn.
When you learn the real truth.
And the interest.
Cold heart.
Okay, sorry.
Then, okay. And then I think from there, I remember during Teacher's Day, there was this performance by my friends, my juniors. Then I saw my friend, she was playing bass. And then they were performing like Smoke on the Water, and immediately I was drawn to it.
A girl playing bass, right, actually.
Yeah, I mean, like, you know, because at that, during high school, you know, during those years when you're studying, you don't really see many music acts at that time. You don't really go out to see like, hey, let's go and check out bands to perform, like, you know, like, but you don't really get that during those days. But at that time, that was my first time exposed to live performance in a way, and it was a girl playing the bass that really got me into it.
Doris.
Then so ever since that, I got the interest to take up music, but only when my friend started asking me like, hey, you know what, let's form a band and start jamming. Then I was like, yeah, why not? And the first instrument that I thought of was just bass straight away.
What was your band's name?
Atria.
Atria, like the club.
The shopping mall, Atria. I had no idea why. My friends suggested that.
Wonder where you heard that.
Cool name.
I know, but we opened for Dragon Raid. That was my first public performance, actually. After high school.
They were okay.
Yeah.
Dragon Raid were alright.
So, but my parents didn't encourage me to study music, so I had to take up mass comm. Then I dropped out for obvious reasons because I wasn't into it. Then, but even though I was already like busy performing, right, since high school until now, then my parents like they kind of like saw that I'm really, passionate about doing music. So they were like, okay, why not? You can just go ahead and study music. So yeah, the rest is history. That's why that's how I got into it.
So you studied music where?
Aswara. Me and Kevin, we came from the same college, actually.
The program is 2 years, ah?
3 years.
Three years.
Yeah, but I took 4 years because I kind of feel
subjects. Okay, yeah, it happens. And they taught you theory and how to play and everything. Every instrument or just a particular instrument?
Well, instrument of your choice, lah.
Like we
do a minor. Do you have to do a minor?
I got such a bad joke for that.
Say it. Say it, please. For a minor.
Did you do a minor?
I did do a minor.
Is it hard in here?
Okay. 2 seconds for the boys to chill down.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Four years.
Did you do the minor?
That's the Crossfire. You're listening to Crossfire.
Okay, my batch, we are not obliged to take up a minor.
So you can say minor instrument.
Yeah,
minor instrument.
because it's illegal. That's why.
Yes. But we were encouraged to take up a minor instrument.
Second instrument.
What was yours?
So sitar.
Wow.
First reason because to break the Chinese stereotype, like, you know, Chinese, you should learn Chinese instruments, yeah, whatever. But I was always like drawn to Indian culture since probably because one of my first girlfriends is like Indian.
Nice. How much havoc did she cause?
It only lasted for 2 months, so
there you go. There you go, Lohes.
Okay.
Never mind. I still haven't been out with an Indian girl, so I'm,
I know,
sure. My jaw right now is on the floor.
Okay, but never mind. So yeah, I took up sitar as my second instrument, mm-hmm, other than bass, mm-hmm, and I learned piano. Guitar is a self-taught. Ukulele after that. That's pretty much it.
So after you broke out with the Indian girl, you immediately picked up the erhu.
I'm playing no Indian instrument no more, son. I'm gonna pick up erhu now.
Do you belong in a band at the moment?
Nah, not in the moment, but I'm just like playing with everyone else. Mm-hmm. Playing with everyone else,
yes, right? Mm-hmm. We got minors.
Look, we got minors and now everyone else.
Exactly.
they like to call me the band slut because I like to play with everyone. So
the band slut.
The band slut from band camp.
It's a popular term.
It's a popular term nowadays.
But I thought they call it a session play or something.
That's the formal way of saying it.
This is a guy playing bass and call him band slut. So girl play bass means how?
Oh, awesome!
Rock on. God.
Yeah. but personally, I do like to play with various types of musicians because I do not want to limit myself. Mm. Yeah, so I guess the more I play with, the more people that I play with, the more happy I am. Mm. That's what I realized after a while.
Mm-hmm. I think that's a general rule on life.
Yes.
True, so the more you play with,
the more people you play with.
Unless you play online games. Then
yeah.
You feel like killing people.
Then you feel like breaking your controller.
Or minor.
Oh my god. Then Joe will now go away right now.
Those are the worst. Minors online.
Okay, what's with Kevin's?
Yeah, Kevin.
Mine's close but slightly different. When I was growing up, after SPM, I was like involved with this band called Qings and Kueens. I met the main singer.
Yeah, I love one of the songs. I forgot.
I heard you guys on radio.
Yeah, it was played on His FM.
Yeah, we were like on the number one of the Malaysian English top 10 for like, I think, 3 weeks. And then then after that, Jacqueline Victor kicked us out within like 1 week. Like, first week we heard her, she was like number 8 something. Next week is like number 1 already.
So you guys have a bad history with Indian women, huh?
Oh wow.
Let's not go there.
Your kryptonite.
Smoke on the water.
Bang.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it was like, that was my first band. I wasn't much of a band slut because I felt like we were really close, lah, that band. We stayed in the same taman in Happy Garden. Then we met our drummer Jerry at the first open mic in Commonwealth Club. And then I think we played for like a good 4 or 5 years from 2004 until about maybe 2008, 2009. And we had fun. We went to Singapore a bit, and that was the furthest we ever traveled as a band, lah.
Malaysia represent.
Yeah.
Represent.
Bro, what instrument were you playing, huh? Sorry?
Electric bass.
Nice.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So after that, I decided to go to Aswara because I couldn't afford ICOM. I actually went to ICOM for like 2 semesters, and during that time,
there was the time I saw you in the LRT.
Yes,
and it was I was going back from college. I saw him.
Oh, okay. You were in Apit, right?
No, I was in Ta.
Ta.
Hey, yeah. I was from Ta.
Oh my god.
Then like during that time, there was this LAN Akreditasi Negara thing, so you had to go and learn calculus and moral studies, and for the life of me, I couldn't get past calculus for 2 semesters.
I couldn't get past moral studies. What happens when you find a wallet? Keep it.
So after that, I was told about Aswara. I went and checked it out, and the fees were really cheap. My dad wasn't too happy, but my mom was very supportive. So I just went to Aswara for 3 years, did my diploma, did my whatever I needed to do, And first job out of school was playing for a musical called Broken Bridges.
Mm-hmm.
And it was like a good run lah for a while. Then after playing with people like Reza Saleh, Mia Palencia, traveling to Sabah to record for Mia. So it was just like...
Which Mia?
Mia Palencia.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah.
Not the black. MIA. Ah, yeah. Yeah. She's not black, she's a contact.
Not the sister. Which, you're talking about the American
UK,
one?
UK
or?
Mia, yeah.
Oh, UK, right.
She's contact.
I mean, really?
Her father's from Sri Lanka.
Oh.
No, her father was a Tamil tiger.
I thought she was a sister. You know what I'm saying?
No, she's Australian.
Really?
Her father's a single a bit of Tamil tiger.
Oh my god, enjoy yourself.
Enjoy.
Okay, back to the story.
two Indians
are debating Indian stuff. Yeah.
So then after that, in 2006, I went to play with a group called Rhapsody with Pichu. And we played the Penang Island Jazz Festival. And when I went for that festival, I fell in love with how everything was run. It was by musicians, for musicians. And it was like a great experience. And after that, I got involved with planning for the festival. And now I work for them. So it was just a natural progression for me from being a young, stupid kid who played bass in the Padang.
To an old, stupid kid playing bass.
Yeah. Now I play bass and I sing like my own songs because I just had stuff to say. For myself and the form of self-expression.
Mm. Yeah, man. Yeah. That's deep.
So that's going on right now.
Mm-hmm. That's very good.
And
that's
what do you think of street musicians then?
Some of them are like really talented. Mm. I like the amount of passion that they have to put themselves out there just to put money on bread, food on the table. Mm-hmm. It's like they know they have a gift and they just want to do it. I mean, it could have started like... I think nobody... as a musician, nobody started to... play music just for the money. Mm-hmm. Everybody started because they love doing it.
Mm-hmm. All because of a girl.
Ah.
Yeah. So it's all
was
about
it
love.
Your case?
That's why he took the sitar.
The proof is out. Come on, man. He took the sitar.
He took the sitar,
but... Yeah. But I think as it evolved, everybody just wanted to make money out of it. But I think for street musicians, it depends though. There are some who like think they're good and they go out and they don't get money in the box or whatever, and then they think, oh, the people don't appreciate me. But sometimes you have to ask yourself, are you really honing your craft?
Okay.
Are you delivering something that people want to hear?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Yeah, there's always something that, as a musician or an artist, you have to ask yourself, are you producing stuff that you like alone? Are you self-indulgent? Or are you producing art?
Okay.
Yeah.
Because there's one thing I believe whereby if a street musician actually make you stop and listen, that is when you owe the guy a buck. Oh, the guy or girl about.
Yeah,
I agree with that as well.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes you get a lot of people who stop and stare for 2 hours and they turn around, walk away, and they go to the Starbucks next door.
but that
also happens.
Yeah, that is actually
but
very sad.
But the street musicians culture is becoming more prominent here in Malaysia.
We call it busking, right?
Yeah, because before this, there was never a term called busking. Yeah. Then, like a few years back, then I saw on Facebook, like, busking. Like, what the heck is busking? Then I realized that, oh, it's actually like the street musicians. And nowadays, I have a few friends, they are actually making it as a living in a way. Like, some of them, they will play at Publica, they have a contract with them, and they can earn like at least about 1,000+ with them. And then they can play with other
in a week?
Users.
$1,000 in a week?
$1,000+ a month.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah, that's quite decent in a way.
But how long do they play? I mean, how many days or just one day?
If I'm not mistaken, maybe about 2 days in a week.
Mm-hmm.
So other days you can play in other places. But
wow.
Yeah, but that's the thing. Like, these days there's like a lot of variety of forms in terms of music entertainment. If you want to enjoy music, you can go to like pubs or whatever, see cover bands, they'll play cover songs. And some, then there's a original, like, those bands or artists, they'll make original music, and street musicians, then there's YouTube musicians. Yeah, I can say that in terms of the local scene over here, is definitely getting better and better compared to last time.
Crossfire on Durian ASEAN.